This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, oh, he's back. How lucky are we? Chef Gerry DuPont from Edible Creations by Gerry is here. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Always nice to see you.
Nice to see you as well.
I like to bring it in that way. A pleasure to have you here. Today we're making blueberry peach cobbler.
It's a recipe that even you can make,
you
Brendan.
Heard it. Yes, well, take us through some of the ingredients and I will do my best to follow along, my friend.
I've actually added on something that's not on the website, but a blueberry sauce. Consists of a little bit of cinnamon, sugar, equal parts sugar, equal parts sugar, blueberries, and water, and a dash of lemon.
All right.
The cobbler consists of sugar, flour. You can use whole wheat flour if you'd like.
Okay.
Whole milk, you can use skim if you'd like. Butter, vanilla, bourbon vanilla.
You have my attention.
Salt and baking powder.
Outstanding. And you'll
and
take,
fresh fruit.
As always, a key ingredient. And you will take us through, as you do every time you hear, the steps. So you'll simplify it. You'll tell us all about what's happening at Edible Creations by Gerry. You must be having a great time servicing the people, doing what it is you do.
This is the crazy time of the year.
Yeah.
It's full swing, pardon the pun, at Montauk Country Club.
Right.
All the other country clubs that we service for desserts are in full swing. It's a busy time. Wedding season.
Sure. Whenever you drop by, you always bring some delectable delights. The cinnamon, the sticks, fantastic. Everything you do, always top notch. Now, Gerry, my mom is here today watching the Rhode Show. She made blueberry muffins. I smell a bake-off.
Let's go, Mom. Come on.
He's ready to go. This is the guy. He's Chef Gerry DuPont from Edible Creations by Gerry. He'll be taking us through the steps of the blueberry peach cobbler all morning. And you said it. I'll be able to do this.
You said cobbler.
Cobbler. Cobbler. You want cobbler?
Cobbler.
I say cobbler. Well, we'll figure it out as the morning rolls on. For now, back over to you. We want to send it back into the kitchen. It's Will and Gerry. Take it away, guys.
That's right. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. Gerry DuPont is here from Edible Creations. By Gerry. We've got blueberry peach cobbler on the menu.
That's what
we're making.
Hi,
today.
Gerry.
Yeah. Hi, Gerry. How are you?
Good. How are you?
All right. What do we got going on, Gerry?
We are going to start with the blueberry sauce.
Okay.
You actually can make any kind of sauce. Raspberry sauce, strawberry sauce. You could even make a peach sauce if you wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
But the sauce basically start with the equal parts of whatever berry you choose.
Get some fresh blueberries here. I love those.
Blueberries. This is a half a cup of water. Okay. Half a cup of sugar.
Mm-hmm.
A little dab cinnamon. A little dab will do you.
Got it.
And then a little bit of lemon juice, fresh lemon juice.
Nice.
You want to bring this to a boil.
Okay.
Stir it up.
Now, are we mushing up those blueberries,
no,
or just letting them be?
Once you bring it up to a boil, the berries will start to pop.
Okay.
And then you want to turn it down to a simmer and let it simmer for about 10 minutes, and you'll see it thicken up. And then as you refrigerate it, it'll thicken up even more.
Okay, and that's because the sugar and everything else that's in the sugar will melt away?
And this is great just on vanilla ice cream.
Oh, man.
I brought some vanilla ice, nice Haagen-Dazs vanilla
ice
cream. Yeah, for the cobbler,
That's great, Gerry.
Right? He's all excited about the cannolis and the ice cream.
Gerry, it's the little things that make you happy after a while. You just go, okay, you got ice cream, I'm happy.
We're actually going to prep up some peaches. The recipe that I use calls for peeling it, but I like to peel.
Okay.
It's my friend. I keep the peels on it.
Got it. So what do we need to do? You got the peaches right there.
We're just gonna have them and then take the pit
out.
Sometimes it's
a little tougher to get out.
Stubborn.
Right. That's a tough one to get
out. Cut it out.
So
you want to use about four peaches for this recipe.
Okay. All right, cool. So we're going to put this together. We are going to talk with Gerry about everything that he has going on. And he always brings a ton of pastries every time he comes in. We'll sample those as well. Back to you. Edible Creations by Gerry. This guy, let me tell you, he does not come empty-handed when he comes to this
Never.
Party all the time. He brings lots of pastries, always makes mm-hmm. something sweet and delicious, and that's what he's doing again today.
Never salmon.
Never.
Never. Never. As you can see.
You know, we like the sweet
right?
here.
As you can see, our sauce
really did break down.
It's broken down. It's
yep.
starting to thicken up. What we're doing here is melting the butter.
Okay.
Butter. This is a simple. You can't get any more simple than this. The butter gets poured in a greased 11-ish by 8 pan.
Mm-hmm.
And then everything gets mixed in. We're going to pour the peaches into our sugar and cinnamon.
Mm-hmm.
You were saying earlier, too, that this is not, technically, it's not a cobbler.
It's called a...
Crumble.
What was the term
It's actually
it?
Called a crumble.
A crumble.
Oh, that's right.
No, a buckle.
A
Sorry.
Buckle. I was going to say, I feel like this was being
said. I'm talking about.
I don't believe either way.
Right? Right?
The bottom there buckles.
It's called
over
a buckle because of the butter, and once we pour the batter on top of that and put the peaches or whatever fruit on top, the when you bake it, it buckles over. So, folks out there that are technical and say this is not a cobbler, they're right. A cobbler is basically doing what I'm doing here with the fruit, with the sugar and the cinnamon, and then dolloping like a dumpling on top and then cooking it.
Interesting.
So basically for the batter, we're going to put the flour, the sugar, salt, vanilla.
It smells good.
And the milk.
And
if you want to whisk that together, you...
Sure. While I do that, the fruit that you selected were peaches, which are great this time of year. But what if I want to make this, you know, in the colder months?
Well, I use canned peaches.
Okay.
They work out really well. I use a 29-ounce can of halved peaches. Not as good as
the fresh stuff.
As the fresh peaches, but
it'll still taste yummy.
And with Haagen-Dazs vanilla ice cream and blueberry sauce, you can't go wrong. So Michaela is mixing up our batter. I think that's pretty good.
Okay.
Fabulous. Then you want to just pour your batter over the butter. I know it sounds strange, but it works.
We believe you. As long as it tastes good.
Right. And then just place your peaches or strawberries right over the top. Spread them all evenly.
You could even probably combine, right?
This
time of year, I know berries are so abundant and you've got
some
nice
of our
peaches.
Blueberries. I brought fresh cherries because I love cherries.
Me too.
Just pit them, put them right in the bottom here.
Right. Okay.
Or you're going to get a really crunchy bite.
We're going to put this in the oven, 375 for about 30 minutes.
Okay.
Okay.
And
look at that.
Voila.
Whoa, look at this.
Whoa. See, I have asbestos hands. I can take it right out of the oven.
Wow.
This is what it looks like after it's finished.
So it really does. It really does kind of.
It buckles up.
In case
we save a few for everybody else.
For
snacking.
Why not? Can we also talk about, too, if fruit isn't quite your dessert thing, I mean, how about some chocolate?
We have chocolate Oreo cookies and cream. We can't technically call them Oreos.
Right.
I call them cookies and cream. And for you, Michaela, because I know you love Oreos.
I do.
And cannolis for my buddy Will.
I love cannolis, too, yeah.
They are delicious.
But you're going on vacation, so you got to get into your Speedo.
You know what? At this point, I don't think it's... I don't know about Speedo, but whatever.
Yeah, eat up. But these are a lot of things that people can find from you. I mean, you make just about everything.
Everything from salmon.
Yeah, well, that's all right.
To cupcakes.
To cupcakes.
We have a very diverse clientele.
Yeah, a lot of different things that you got going on. All right, so now we need ice cream, right?
Absolutely.
All right, so where's the ice cream? Let me grab of the ice cream out of here.
I'll grab a plate.
Okay, we got ice
or
cream.
Or a bowl. What do we think? How about this plate, which is...
Could go festive and put it in one glass.
Kind of both.
This. Got some Haagen-Dazs.
I'm gonna see what that's like in the middle. Oh my goodness.
Put this right there for you, Gerry.
Wow.
Am I going in there with the same spoon?
Dash it.
Yeah.
You're all friends.
We're all friends.
Oh my
God.
Well, that was like one of those mind tricks. He just bent the spoon.
Here's an ice cream scoop,
it's like,
Gerry.
Yeah, I saw that right before my eyes. The spoon just bent.
There we go.
Oh, my God.
The psychic dudes.
Oh, my gosh. It is so frozen. Okay, we've got a scoop here, and then we need to top it with that sauce.
Right?
That
Now, you really do want to cool this off before you put
it
on.
Well, the ice cream's hard enough. You could probably use a little melting.
A little bit. Ooh, look at that, huh?
There you go.
Oh, my goodness.
That's good.
Who's better than this?
Nobody.
Nobody.
Gerry.
That looks
Gerry.
Delicious to me.
Wrong show.
Okay, if you...
Dig in.
If you want this recipe, you know where to go. Head on over to roadshow.com.